Hey guys, Big Rob here. I'm just a guy over 50. I don't know shit. I don't care about shit. Just care about mine, my people, my family, my coworkers. Those of you that know me know that I work in an emergency room in the bush in Alaska. I traveled here a number of times and then decided to stay. I just wanted to put a word out there about mask wearing for the layperson. If you're one of those people who is running around down at AMC snapping photographs of the nurses trying to do their job, trying to get one of those I gotcha moments, you know, when they got their mask pulled down around their chin or something, just so you know, those people wear masks 10, 12 hours a day while you wear yours for about 15 minutes and then get tired of it or bored of it and pull it down. And if they want to take a break, they're allowed to do that. And so I think that you should consider the ramifications of the things that you're doing. You're one of those people that wants to get on Facebook and, you know, take these kinds of things to the Facebook jury. I would challenge you to spend 12 hours in the emergency room at AMC and try to follow those people, because you don't have the guts, you don't have the body habitus, you don't have the courage to educate yourself, spend the money, spend the time, educate yourself, and deal with what these nurses and doctors have to deal with. And so snapping photographs of them and trying to catch them doing the wrong thing is counterproductive, and it's fascism. Trying to bully people is fascism. At the VA, we used to call that third-party aggression. You know, you're sitting there, for example, you don't like somebody, you got an axe to grind or a chip on your shoulder, and you decide that, you know, you don't have power over them. You can't project force on them. So you use a system to do it. Take photographs and post them on Facebook and complain. All the nurses aren't doing this or that, or what you think they should be doing. But what do you know about the spread of this disease? Nothing. When was the last time you visited CDC.gov's website and reviewed articles on mask wearing for the layperson? Tons and tons of stuff out there. American Association of Nurses got tons of stuff. Journal of American Medical Association, tons of stuff. Or are you just getting your news from CNN, getting your information from MSNBC or Facebook? You're an idiot. Stop taking photographs of people. Stop trying to bully people. Stop jumping on your neighbors for not doing what you think they should be doing. Oh, and this asshole that got in some dude's face over in Portland at a pizza place for not wearing a mask, guess what you're not doing? Socially distancing. You get in my face because you don't think I'm wearing a mask right? You're liable to get your fucking teeth knocked out. Don't do it. Social distancing, good hand washing. Don't approach me or my family. Don't challenge me about it. 20 years experience as a nurse in an EMS, flight nurse, transport nurse, ICU, ER, oncology. This is out of control, people. You need to control yourselves. Maintain yourselves. Your health is your responsibility. Not the government's, not your doctor's. It's up to you to take your pills, exercise, and eat right. If you're an alcoholic with bad lungs, guess what? Whether you're 50 years old or 70 years old, if you get this, you're gonna get sick. You may even die. So don't go to the store unless you plan on washing your hands and staying 6 to 10 feet away from people. There ain't a can of beans out there worth your life. Oh, and one more thing. I got these in the mail the other day. I don't remember who I ordered them from because it took like 4 months to show up or 3 months to show up. These guys here, see these face coverings? If you're a person who's out there ordering this stuff or buying it at the AC or Fred Meyer's or Walmart or wherever the hell you're getting this stuff, you can see through this. This little filter or whatever, you can see through this. I can see my hand through it. This isn't doing shit. This, you know what this says about you? That you're willing to shut up. You're willing to comply with whatever the government tells you to do. Whatever your employer tells you to do. It's coming, people. It's coming. I am shocked at the number of Americans that are rolling over for this. And nurses, stay at the bedside. Stay out of the politics. Do your job. The vitriolic grandstanding, that's got to stop. Do your job. That's all. That's all you got to do. Show up. Do the work. Hell, you might even accomplish something great if you think about it. But this whole thing where we're out berating people, or the lay public is at war with nursing, snapping our photographs, screaming and yelling at us? That all ends now. You want our help? You want us to spend the money on our education and our free time taking care of you? You can't even bother to wash your hands? You know what? Next time you got the sniffles, don't come to the emergency room. See your doctor. Hell, see a nurse practitioner, a PA. Go to a 24-hour clinic. Don't be one of those douchebags that goes to the emergency room because you hurt your finger a week ago. Okay, you're clouding up the works. Real people out there aren't coming to the emergency room, aren't seeking health care for chest pain, shortness of breath, abdominal pain. Old people are dying because you think this is a good idea and you're willing to whoop somebody's ass over it. It all ends now. When you wear that mask, when you roll over for this mayor in Anchorage, you're telling him that you're compliant, that you're willing. You're not showing him the American, the Alaskan defiant side, the hard work and the dedication to your lives. You're not showing him that. You're showing him you're willing to bend over for a Marxist. That all ends now. Stop berating your nurses. Stop bullying the paramedics. Stop criticizing the doctors. And stop taking pictures of us. It's not going to work. We are not going to be intimidated by you. You will not browbeat us. You will not beat us down. It just won't happen. Leave the nurses alone. Let them do their work. Taking care of our elders. And our most helpless, the people we cherish the most, our elders. This is Big Rob. I'm just a guy over 50. What do I know?